Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Right wherever you are, what you ought to be doing is you ought to be worshiping the Lord. Amen. Don't watch the screen right now. Just close your eyes. Amen. Lift your hands up to the Lord and just let that be your prayer. Let that be your praise this morning. I love you, Lord. I love you with all my heart. I love you with all my soul. I love you with all my mind. I love you with all my being. Let's worship the Lord. I don't want you watching. I don't want you spectating right now. I want you to lift your hands right where you are. Amen. And just say, I love you, Lord. I love you. I love you. I love you. Lord, forgive me, Lord, for going astray. I love you. I thank you, Lord, that you never left me. I thank you, Lord, that you never forsaken me, Lord. Forgive me for doubting you, Lord, right? Forgive me for being walking in fear when I shouldn't walk in faith, when I should be walking in faith, Lord. So right now, Lord, I'm committing my heart to you. I want to be, I'm fully committed to you, Lord, right now. Fully committed to your way. Fully committed to your plan. Fully committed to your desire. Lord, I want to be sold out to you, Lord, right now, Lord. I want my heart to be sold out, my mind to be sold out, to my spirit to be sold out to you right now, Lord. Lord, I love you. Hallelujah. I want to love you more than anything. I want to desire you more than anything, more than riches, because money can't give you all the joy that you need. More than relationships, because other folk may fail you. I want a relationship in you that will never fail, Lord. So I want you to be the center of my joy, the center of my love, the center of my heart, the center of my purpose, the center of my desire, the center of all my passion. Lord, I want to love you more than anything. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I love you. Hallelujah. I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord, for you are all everything, Lord. You're everything. Hallelujah. Lord, forgive us when we haven't put you at the center of all of our desires. Put you at the center of our life. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Let's just worship him. Amen. Hallelujah. I know you're in your curlers. I know you're in your bathrobe. I know you got your house shoes on, but let's just worship the Lord right now. Nobody's looking at you. Nobody cares. Nobody's looking. Just go ahead and lift your hands up to the Lord and say, Lord, I thank you. Lord, I thank you for being so good. I thank you anyway. I thank you, Lord, for the difficulties I'm going through right now, because I know you're going to bless me. I know you're going to turn it around. And so I want to love you right now. I want to love on you. When they would say, bless the Lord, all my soul, and all that is within me. Blessing the Lord is showering the Lord with love. Lord, I love you. Lord, I thank you. Lord, I praise you. You deserve all the honor. You deserve all the glory. Come on now, let's love on the Lord. Let's love on God right now. Let's love on the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Love on him. Hallelujah. Love on him. Love on him. Let him know how much you love him. Sometimes you gotta tell somebody that you love them. Don't just not say it, but you gotta say it. Sometimes you gotta say, Lord, I love you. But you can't just say it. You gotta let it be in your actions. Love is a verb. You gotta love them every day. Love them in what you say. Love them in what you do. Hallelujah. Love him. Love him. Love him. Love him. Hallelujah. To God be the glory. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Praise God. I love you. Lord, I love you. Amen. It's all right. We have a praise break. You know, a lot of times I see people do their virtual services and they want to rush through it. Amen. But if we were together in the physical, we wouldn't rush through it. So we're not going to rush through it virtually. We're not going to rush through it. We're going to give him praise. Amen. We're going to give him glory. We set aside this time. Amen. Praise God. If we were together, we would just be getting, amen, to the second or third song. Amen. So we haven't even been in worship that long. So we're not going to rush it. We're going to give God all his praise, give God all his glory. Just because we're worshiping virtually doesn't mean we're going to give God any less. Hallelujah. We're not going to give God any less. We ought to be giving God more. You didn't have to drive. You didn't have to get your suit pressed. You didn't have to put on any clothes or any. You rolled out of bed and worshiped this morning. So we're not going to give God any less. We're going to give God everything he deserves. For he is good. And as the old saints would say, he's good all the time. Praise God. To God be the glory. Y'all ready to get into this word? Now let me let you know Last week, I was preaching real good, I thought, and I thought the Lord was moving, but then my stomach got really upset. I had to cut that thing short on last week, and I'm not going to lie. Praise God. Thank God for Sister Hodge to step in to go ahead and give that invitation on last week. And so if the sermon felt a little bit short last week, because it was, but I just was not feeling that great, and I thank people for the prayers. Amen. And so I may recap a little bit of last week's sermon, bring it on into this week's sermon. Praise God, because I just was not feeling my best on last Sunday. I was good till about 10 minutes into that thing. I was not feeling all that great. Praise the Lord. But I feel 100 times better. And those who gave me advice on last week on what to do, I followed your advice. Praise God. I did exactly what the mothers told me to do. Praise the Lord. Now, let's go back to Genesis 24. This is where we're going to leave today, start today. Amen. Praise God. Genesis chapter 24. And if you don't mind, let's set the scene here. Abraham has sent out one of his trusted servants to go and travel 500 plus miles. Some scholars say 500, some say almost as long as 850 miles. Even though it's a couple of verses, it took him a long time to get there. And he's praying when he shows up to a town, and he says, Lord, you know, guide me, direct me, lead me to the person that you want me to find for to be the wife for my master's son. Amen. And so the servant is praying, and while he's praying, amen, the Bible says that Rebecca, amen, shows up near a well where he is praying to draw water, and he sees this woman. And we're going to use Rebecca as the center of our lesson this morning. For in verse 45, it says this. This is the servant saying, but he's talking to the family. He is now telling the family how he realized Rebecca was the one that God has sent. He is retelling the story. Amen. He says, before I finished praying in my heart, that means he wasn't bowed in prayer, but he was just kind of observing things, and he's praying. And the Bible says, before he even finished praying, he sees Rebecca at the well. Amen. And I want to preach from the subject this morning. Your blessing is looking for you. Oh, man, write that down. Write that down. Write that down. Your blessing is looking for you. Praise God. Praise God. I'm going to use that as our subject this morning. Your blessing is looking for you. Let's go to God in prayer. Gracious Father, we ask right now for your spirit. We ask right now that you would have your way in this moment, in this place. Speak, Holy Spirit. Give us everything we need right now so that we might grow in grace and grow in understanding. We ask right now that your spirit would move. Lord, move me out of the way so your divine and holy word can be heard. Speak now. Lord, give me an anointing right now that makes preaching and teaching easy. Speak now, Holy Spirit, in Jesus' name. And all the people of God said, amen. A blessing is looking for you. Amen. Type that. Type that. Type that in the chat. A blessing is looking for you. Praise God. Oftentimes we are looking for our blessing, not knowing that our blessing is looking for us. Our blessing is hunting us down. Amen. I want to minister from that idea, and I'm going to use Rebecca as the center of our message, because I believe, amen, Rebecca is not necessarily talk much about in this passage, but I do believe, amen, she had been waiting on a blessing, praise God, not knowing on that particular day her blessing was going to show up and find her. She did not know her blessing was looking for her. And so I just want to encourage somebody today, encourage somebody under the sound of my voice, under that you can see me. I want to encourage you today, amen, don't worry, amen, don't fret. Your blessing is looking for you, and your blessing is going to find you. Praise God. That's the good news right there, that God has orchestrated and God has organized things, and God has sent a blessing your way. Amen. All you need to do is be in the right spot when it shows up. I think back nearly, it was 20 years ago, almost to the date. I had been doing a funeral on the South Side. I was driving through South Side when I got a phone call. It was a phone call call from Pastor Lawrence Samuels, and he said, Brother Hodge, and he would say, young man, where are you? I said, well, Pastor, I am on South Side. I just did a funeral. I'm heading back to St. Paul's Baptist Church. At the time, I was working as a minister, associate minister at St. Paul's Baptist Church in the East End of Henrico, and Pastor Samuels, the pastor of this particular church, Amen, Second Baptist, when we were on Pilkington Street, he called me and said, can you come through 105 East Pilkington Street? That's our old location, and speak to me for just a moment. Now, Pastor Samuels had always been good to me. He'd always allowed me in the month of August to come and preach for him when he would go on vacation. He would go on vacation the whole month of August, and he would ask me to come during that month to preach. So in my mind, I'm thinking, oh, he's going to ask me to come thank me for preaching, or ask me to come preach, amen, for in the month of August, like he normally would do. So as a young preacher, you get excited about folk asking you to preach and doing stuff like that. So I quickly made my way over to 105 East Pilkington Street to speak to Pastor Lawrence Samuel. And as we sat down, he spoke to me, and he told me something. I thought he was going to give me an invitation to preach. That's what I was expecting. That's what I was looking for, but what he told me, he said, at the end of this year, this is 2000, he said, at the end of the year 2000, I am going to retire. I'm not going to be the pastor. I'm going to retire as pastoring of the church. He had pastored 30 plus years, and he was letting me know. He said, now Baptist churches do think what's called a pastoral search, and you got to put your resume in and go through a long process, but what he was letting me know at that particular time was, if you are looking for a church at the first of the year, Second Baptist probably will be looking for a pastoral candidates to interview. And anybody know the pastoral candidacy process is a long process. And so I left that afternoon, amen, not knowing what the future would hold, not knowing what God would do, but he tracked me down. And so what I realized at that moment, I wasn't going to be the pastor of Second Baptist that next week or that next month, but a seed was sown in my spirit of the possibility of me becoming the pastor of Second Baptist Church. Now I had to, at St. Paul's at the time, I had a really great position at the church. I had a really great spot. I had a really great job. I was being paid very well, but I believe that God was stirring something up, amen, in 2000. Now, if you know the history of me and Second Baptist, I didn't become the pastor until 2003, nearly 2.5 years later from that moment that I had run, that Pastor Samuels called me up, tracked me down, and had me come to his office. But I do believe when I look back on it, that my blessing was running me down, tracking me down, making sure that I was in the right place at the right time to be able to do the right thing. And I'm here to let you know that your blessing will track you down. Your blessing is looking for you. And I have to tell you why that is important. You say, Pastor, why is that so important? Because the following day, the pastor at my home church in Fort Washington, Maryland, decided he was going to retire as well. Now, if anybody knows me, they know that I love my hometown, Fort Washington, Maryland. But because Pastor Samuels at Second Baptist told me about Second Baptist before I heard about Fort Washington Baptist Church, the Lord had let me know, I know you would love to go back to Fort Washington, but Richmond is where you are staying. I know you would love to go back home because that's where you were raised. That's your people. But I'm using you in Richmond. You're not leaving Richmond, Virginia. And I say that to somebody because what people don't know is that I have been wanting to be a pastor since 95, and this is now 15 years later. And in those 15 years, I had been waiting on the Lord. I had been praying to God. I had been asking God to bless me, amen, to be able to use my pastoral gift somewhere where I could grow with the Lord and be used by God and do ministry. But I had to wait 15 15 years, amen, and I had to wait on the Lord. I had to trust God, and I said, God, I know you got something for me, but I have to wait. Now, the question you're saying now, Pastor, what do you need to do, amen, when your blessing is looking for you? What do you need to do when your blessing finds you? What do you need to do? I know God has a blessing for me, Pastor. I know there's some stuff. Can I help you? Something came up on my timeline that I said last week, that I said last year, and it said God is working on something in secret so he can bless you in public. Okay, y'all missed that. Y'all should have wrote that down. God is working on something in secret so he can bless you in public. Oh, okay, you didn't get it. Look, God is working on something in secret that he's going to do, bless you in public. That's a shout right there, because that helps me, because even when I don't think God is working on stuff for me, God is working on stuff for me. Even when I don't feel like things are going right, God is working on stuff for me. Amen. I couldn't pastor church in 95. I wasn't ready to pastor church in 98. I wasn't ready to pastor church in 2000. But by the time 2002 and 2003 came around, God had got me in a place where I was ready for the blessing that he had on my mind. Let me tell you, that I had. Understand that God already knew that I was going to be the pastor before the foundations of the world, before I was formed in my mother's womb. I didn't know until 2002, 2003. But God had already been working on that thing. He was working on the congregation. He was working on the deacons. He was working on the trustees. He was working on the music ministry. He was working on me. He was doing some stuff in my life. He was doing some stuff in my wife's life. He was doing some stuff in my children's life. He was getting everything ready. He was working on my money. He was putting things in order. He was working on my house. What I'm trying to tell you, God was working on some stuff for me to be where I was supposed to be, even though I didn't know that's where I was going. Oh, you're not hearing what I'm trying to tell you here. God is working on some stuff in secret so he can bless you with some stuff in public. Oh, let's give God some praise today. He's got a blessing, and he sent that blessing to find you. Oh, that blessing is on the way. Oh, somebody ought to shout right now. It's on the way. It's on the way. It's on the way. Here we have Sister Rebecca. Oh, put yourself in her shoes. She's a young woman living with her mommy and daddy and her brother. Amen. And she is just waiting on God. And back then, it was a girl's dream to find a Prince Charming. It was a girl's dream to find a man that would be a husband to her. That was a big deal. Amen. We don't, now it's not as big of a deal, but back then that was huge. That was the biggest thing. Amen. And you got to put yourself in her shoes. She is just every day, you know, it doesn't seem like any prospects, doesn't seem like anybody likes her, doesn't seem like anybody's talking to her, it doesn't seem like her mom and daddy approves of anyone. You got to put yourself in her shoes. She's just every day going back and forth to the well every day to get water, to feed the sheep, to feed the cows, to feed the camels. Every day she is going back and forth to the well. She's got to go when it's hot. She's got to go when it's cold. She got to drop that bucket in the well every day. It would seem like this is so monotonous. It would seem like this is just run of the mill. You got to play it out in her mind. Every day she's walking to the well, it's another day at the well. It's another day I'm dropping down something and I'm pulling up something. I'm dropping down and I'm putting up something. Every day it's monotonous. Every day it's routine. Every day it's getting tired. Anybody been in that kind of situation where it seems like you're just going through the motions? It seems like you're just doing the same old, same old. It just seems like nothing's changing. It seems like, look, you're getting older and it doesn't seem like anything's changing. It doesn't seem like anything's happening for you. You're seeing other girls getting married. You're seeing other people get blessed. You're wondering, when is it going to be your time? You're wondering, when is it going to be your moment? Well, you're wondering, when is it going to be your day? You're wondering, when is it going to be your time to shine? You're just going over through the motions. Oh, put yourself in her shoes every day, going back and forth to the well, to the point now, going and forth to the well don't even really bother you anymore. You've gotten real strong now, so strong when somebody brings some camels. You can go dip in that well 80 times and not break a sweat. Still have a smile on your face. Pastor, what are you getting to? Your blessing is looking for you. And when your blessing finds you, the way your blessing's going to find you is that it finds you being faithful. Oh, write that down. Write that down. Write that down. Your blessing needs to find you faithful. Here is the servant of Abraham going about his work to find a young lady for his master's son. And he prays a specific prayer. He says, Lord, when I get there, let her, when I ask for a drink, let her not only offer me a drink, but let her say, hey, I'm going to drink. I'm going to give you camels some water too. I'm going to not only give you a drink, I'm going to let you make sure your camels get plenty of water. Now camels can drink a lot of water. That's a whole lot of water. And she's going down. Even if it was one camel, it would have been a lot of water. Sister girl, amen, is going to take care of all of the camels. And look, she's able to do this. She doesn't mind offering it to him, because at this point in her life, giving that many camels water is nothing. At this moment in her life, her faithfulness has prepared her to be faithful in this situation. Oh, y'all, I'm not trying to help somebody right now. Amen. You're saying, what do I need to do while I'm waiting on my blessing? Just be faithful. Just do the task that you were assigned. I'm sure some people said, oh, I don't want to go and get any water today. I don't want to go out there today and get any water. I don't want to have to go down into the well again. Every time I've gone up in the width of the well, it just seems like the same old, same old. I'm so grateful that she was faithful on that day. Just think what would have happened if she had pissed a hissy fit that day and decided, I don't feel like going to the well today. Just what would have happened if she made a decision, I ain't gonna do it today, mama. I'm tired. Get somebody else to do it. Let Laban go out there and get it. Let my own, somebody else in the family, let some of my cousins get the water. What would have happened if on that day she hadn't have been as faithful, if that day she hadn't have been doing what she had to do, what seemed to be routine, what seemed to be mundane? Can I help you? Your blessing is going to find you in the mundane. Your blessing is going to find you in the regular's way. You are being faithful today. Just be faithful as a dad. Just be faithful as a mom. Just be faithful as an employee. Just be faithful as a servant of the Most High. Just do what you're supposed to do, when you're supposed to do it, like you're supposed to do it, and do it with a smile on your face. Do it better than you do, than you're asked to do. Amen. Look what she does. The Bible says, he asked her, can I get a drink? She said, I will give you a drink. But then he doesn't ask, will you give my camels a drink? That's something that she offers. Oh, you know, listen to me, what I'm saying. She goes the extra mile. I'm here to ask, is there anybody who's going to be faithful with a smile? Is there anybody that's going to be faithful and go the extra mile? Is there anybody that's going to be faithful and do what you're supposed to do and then some? You're going to put some extra on it. Amen. You're going to season what you do with grace. You're not just doing it, but you do it with a smile. You just don't do it, but you do it with joy. You just don't do it, but you're glad that you had the opportunity to do it. Somebody like her, she's glad to be a servant. She's glad to offer herself. She's glad to go the extra mile. Amen. Those are the kind of folk that blessings are looking for. You go the extra mile. You do what's extra. Now, she had been doing this, going to this well every day. God knows how many days, how many years she had done this simple task. But can I help you? Be faithful in the simple things. Oh, I'm trying to bless somebody today. Be faithful in the mundane things. Be faithful in the things that don't get you any pats on your back, don't get you any accolades, don't get you any. Look, he didn't come to the town and say, who's the prettiest girl? He didn't come to the town, who's the girl everybody's trying to get with? Who's the girl that got her hair fried and laid to the side? Who's the pretty? No, he showed up at the well. Oh, y'all know me. He showed up at a place where somebody works. He showed up to the place where somebody has to be faithful. Oh, she's pretty, but she ain't a prima donna. Oh, she's cute, but she's not so cute where she can't get her hands dirty and do what she has to do. Oh, let's give God some praise for some faithful folk. Give God some praise for some folk that don't mind working a little extra and going the extra mile. That's the kind of person that blessings are looking for. Amen. Look, if she hadn't have shown up that day, my God, she would have missed out on a blessing. I'm trying to help somebody today. You got to be faithful in the things that you're supposed to do. Can I help you? Now, what happened to me between that time that Pastor Lawrence Samuel spoke to me and the time that I became the pastor of Second Baptist Church? The Lord clearly told me St. Paul's was moving to the county. Right when Pastor Samuel had spoken to me, we had already purchased land in off of Creighton Road, and we were going to build, and we made a decision. We weren't going to be in the city, but we were going to be in the county as a church, St. Paul's. God specifically told me, you're not leaving the city of Richmond. You're staying in the city, but I'm going to test you to be faithful. I'm going to test you on your faithfulness. Now, I have to admit, I didn't think it would take Second Baptist 2.5 years to make a decision. It took a little bit of time, but that was God testing me. Amen. How many know your God may test you, and it may, your test may go a little longer than you expected. The test, because what was going on with me as God was working on Second Baptist on Southside, God was working on me in the East End. I don't know all of what he was doing with Second Baptist, but can I tell you what he was doing with me? He had to make sure I could be somebody that could pastor a church. He had to make sure I could be somebody that was going to walk in integrity. He had to make sure I got rid of some stuff that wasn't any good for me and grabbed a hold of some stuff that I was going to need. He had to make sure that I cut some stuff back and put some stuff on. He had to make sure that I was ready. So he had put me at St. Paul's through a series of tests, through a series of trials, through a series of where I questioned, should I even be in ministry? I questioned if I won't even do it, but God had put me through some tests. Will you do the right thing when it ain't popular? Will you say the right thing when it's not popular? Will you hold folk accountable when it's not popular? God had put me through a series of tests and to see if I was going to be faithful, see if I was going to break under pressure. He had to show me how to deal with some folk that were not lovable on one side of town. So when I came on the other side, if anybody came to me looking crazy, I came back with a smile. I don't always do it, but I tried my best. Amen. And been trying my best. But he was working on me, making sure my family was ready, making sure my kids was ready. He had to do some stuff in our lives, amen, so that we would be ready when we came on the other side. And I'm here to let you know, God wants you to be faithful in what you're doing. You know, your blessing ain't going to show up, amen, when you're not doing the right thing, but it's going to show up right where you're being faithful. Good God Almighty. The Lord, and from 2000 to 2003, the Lord was testing me to see if I would be faithful, to see if I would do the right thing, and see if I would honor God. I didn't always pass all of your tests, but God would give me a retest. Amen. I didn't get it right. He said, oh, not now, go back and do it again. And I was clear. Let me tell you something. In 2001 and 2002, I was clear, amen, that there was some stuff that wasn't going to happen for me if I wasn't going to be faithful in a couple of things that God had put before me. I was confident of that. And so, look, I'm telling you, your blessing is looking for you, and the first thing you need to know so that it finds you is that you're being faithful. What Rebecca did not know is that all of this was orchestrated by God. What Rebecca did not know is that God was all in the midst of this thing. Even though she was going about her daily routine, what she didn't know, 800 miles away, God had dispatched her blessing. God had dispatched the next chapter in her life. God had dispatched, amen, a wonderful thing for her. She was going to understand this from the time, y'all not hearing me, from the time the servant left Abraham to the time he showed up, Rebecca, just in that time alone, probably had gone to that well more than 100 times that she had gone to that well, over and over and over, and every chance she went, there was a time for her to say, you know what, I'm tired of doing this. I'm tired of going, I'm too cute to do this. I shouldn't have to do that. But guess what? Nobody's too cute to be faithful. Oh, hear me now, beloved. She was faithful in this. God was moving on one side of the nation to send her a blessing, and God's got a blessing. He sent it to you, and you want that blessing to find you faithful. Lord, so amen. So the first thing I need you to understand, you've got to be faithful. Amen. Not only should you be faithful, look what the servant does. The Bible says that as soon as he found Sarah, if you look at it, as soon as he found that, the Bible says, amen, in verse 48, that he bowed down and worshiped the Lord. Amen. I'm telling you, amen, you want to be faithful and you want to be grateful. You want to be faithful and you want to be thankful. You want to be faithful, you want to be grateful. You want to be faithful, you want to be thankful. Amen. What God is looking for is thankful people. The servant of God is thankful, and Rebecca is excited. The servant of God, he gives her a ring for her nose. That was customary in that day. We don't wear them as much now, but it was customary then, and he gave her bracelets. What he's doing at this moment, he's giving her, amen, a lot of stuff that is signifying, amen, that is a blessing coming your way. And the Bible says that the servant, because God had been faithful, because God had done so much, the servant now bows down and praises God. Amen. The servant now bows down because he knows God has blessed him. Rebecca has been blessed, and now the servant of God knows that God, check this out, which, look, the servant now sees that God has blessed his efforts. Amen. Rebecca's getting a blessing, and now the servant of God, he says, God has blessed my journey. God has blessed me. Because guess what? The servant didn't know. God sent Rebecca to where the servant was. Hold on now. God sent the servant to Rebecca, but also God sent Rebecca to the servant. So God is moving two things together. So on one side, Rebecca's being faithful. On the other side, the servant is being grateful. Oh, you need both of those, amen, when God is sending a blessing. You need, amen, to be faithful, but you also need to be grateful. Rebecca's getting blessed, but the servant of God had prayed, Lord, bless my journey. Give me success on my journey. When the servant shows up, he didn't know that God had sent him the blessing his way. He showed up right where he was supposed to be, and then God had sent the blessing right where he was. So on one end, God is sending Rebecca, but on the other end, God is sending the servant. Both of them are going to be a blessing to one another. Both of them are the recipients of blessings. And in one case, we see somebody being faithful. On the other side, we see somebody being grateful. He praises God and thanks the Lord. Praise God. God, I thank you for blessing my journey. Lord, you are good. You are awesome. You are faithful. I can't believe it. Amen. Not only did I show up in the right town, not did I show up at the right well, but I found the right girl. Amen. To God be the glory. God had orchestrated everything. So you got to be faithful and you got to be grateful. But can I give you the last one? You got to be ready. Oh, what are you saying, Pastor? You got to be ready. The moment you get this blessing, you got to be ready to walk in it. God be the glory. The Bible says that after the servant retells the story, he says, and the father and the brother says, this is of God. What can we say? There's nothing they can say at this moment. And so the servant, he gives Rebecca all sorts of clothes and jewelry in it, dresses her up, amen, because she got to look good, amen, for her new husband, amen. So he gives her everything, amen. So her attitude is right. She's excited about this thing. He blesses the family with all sorts of good things. They get all sorts of stuff, amen. And the Bible says they have a great feast and go to sleep and wake up the next morning. Then now the next morning, amen. The mother and the son Laban, they come to the servant. They said, the servant says, we're ready to go. We're ready to get out here. The servant is ready. Amen. Rebecca is ready. But mom and the brother said, maybe she ought to stay 10 more days. Maybe she ought to stay with us a little while longer. Maybe we're not ready to let her go. Can I help you? There's some folk, amen, that won't be ready when your blessing comes. There's some people that aren't ready for you to go to your next level. They're not ready to let you go. They're not ready to see you go further. It may not be anything malicious. They're just being selfish. Laban and his mother. Now, this is the best thing that could have happened to this girl's life, and they are trying to delay her blessing. They're trying to hold her back. And can I help you? Some of the folk that are closest to you may not always be ready to let you go to your next level when it's time for you to go to your next level. I'm trying to help somebody. It's not because they're mean. It's not because they're bad people. They just may not be ready. But you got to be ready when God is ready for you to go. I remember when I was telling people at St. Paul's, I was ready to leave. They said, oh, you can't go. What are you doing? And I told them that. They were like, are you sure that's what you want to do? And clearly in my heart and in my mind, I told them, I'm ready to go. Amen. I'm ready to move on to my next level. We had just built a $20 million building. We had done all this stuff on the other side of town. It would seem like that's where you'd want to be. It would seem like that's the place you want to stay. We were already one of the fastest growing churches in Richmond at the time. It may still be, I'm not sure. But it was like, hold on, you sure that's what you want to go? My pastor came to my office. He had never come to my office in 7 years. I would always go to his office. He came to my office, sat down. He said, now tell me again what you told me last night. I said, man, I'm going over to Second Baptist. That's what God has put in my heart. That's what God has moved in my life. I've been waiting on this thing for 2.5 years. I've been hoping and praying that they would call me to be the pastor. I've been hoping and praying that they would say I'm the one. I've been hoping and praying that God had put it on their hearts that this will be a great spiritual marriage between clergy and church. I was praying on this. Nah, man, I've been waiting on this thing. I'm ready for this thing. God has been getting me ready for this thing. And so I don't care what you offer. Amen. You can offer me more money. I ain't going for the money. You can offer me more position. I ain't going for more position. I got to go where God is leading me. I got to go where the plan of God has my name on it. Amen. It's a blessing with my name on it. I'm ready to go to Second Baptist. I'm ready. Look, I really never spent that much time on Southside. Amen. But that's what God was sending me, and I was ready to go. I'm trying to help somebody today when there's some time. Look, when God comes with your next blessing, when God, look, your next opportunity, you can't stay where you where you used to be. God is trying to take you somewhere. God is trying to do something. The Bible says that when they said, can they stay 10 more days? The servant said, do not detain me any longer. God has given me success. Amen. You can't stop the flow. You can't stop this move of God. Don't detain me. They said, well, let's go ask the girl and see what she has to say. Now, let me help you here. Mom and brother were thinking girl was going to say, Rebecca was going to say, yeah, I want to stay a little longer. Let me say goodbye to all my cousins. Let me say goodbye to all my friends. Let me get mama to fry me some chicken one more time. Let me get mama to cook me some candy yams one more time. Let me, you know what, I'm not, let me stay around just a little bit longer. I want to just walk around the field one more time and just picture it in my mind. The Bible says when they get her, they say, will you go with this man? Now, you got to understand this. She just met this brother. You got to understand this. She just don't know these people from Adam. You got to understand this. She's going to some place where she ain't never been to meet up with somebody she ain't never met, to marry a man that she don't know. She don't know if what he looked like. She don't know if he cross-eyed. She don't know if he got buck teeth. She don't know if he bow-legged. She don't know if he pigeon-toed. She don't know if he's shorter than her. She don't know if he's taller than her. She don't know if he's big as a house or as skinny as a needle. She has no clue, but she ready to go. Now, I don't know what is in her heart. All she know is she been waiting on this moment. She's ready to go. And beloved, can I help you? When your blessing finds you, you don't want to look back. You don't want to look to the left. You don't want to look to the right. You just want to look ahead and say, I'll go. Praise God. That's all that need to be said. And they left. Amen. And everybody wished her well. There was somebody that was faithful. There was somebody that was grateful. And then there was two people that were ready to go. The servant was ready to go, and Rebecca was ready to go. When your blessing comes looking for you, you better be ready to receive it. You better be moved and get into action. There's somebody here, you've been waiting on a job. Amen. You may have to wait longer than you expected. But when it comes, you better let them folk find you faithful. You better be grateful for the opportunity, and you better be ready to start day one. You don't need to look every now and then. You ain't got time. The Bible said they got packed and they got on out of here. Amen. Beloved, let me tell you something. When your blessing shows up, don't you be waiting around. Don't you be looking around. It kills me. Folk get a great job opportunity. They say, well, what you talking about? You've been praying on that thing. What you talking about? This is your opportunity. This is your moment. Don't waste it. Jump on it. Don't let it get past you. Beloved, there's some opportunities that are going to come your way. Your blessing's going to show up. God has been working on some stuff you didn't know about. Let God find you faithful. But when it shows up, you better praise God. You better be grateful. You better worship him. You better say, God, you bless me. Success. But look, don't stop at the praise. You be ready to go. You be ready to move forward. Praise the Lord. Some opportunities are coming your way. And when the opportunities come, you got to be ready. But look, first thing is you got to be faithful. Notice all throughout the scripture, Abraham prayed. His servant prayed several times. Now, I didn't even read the end. When they get to, they travel and they get to where they're supposed to be. You got to read the end. The Bible says that Isaac was praying when they find him. Read, you got to read that in the end. The Bible says when you get to the end, then the Bible says this, verse 62, we didn't read it. Now Isaac had come from Beer Lahoroi, and he was living in the Negev. He went out to the field one evening to meditate. Amen. He's just going to sit out there and think on the goodness of the Lord. Now, he doesn't know what the servant has found. He doesn't know the servant is about to show up. He's praying. You know why he's praying? Because he's seen his daddy pray. You know why he's praying? He had seen the servant that Abraham sent out pray. He had grown up in a praying household at this moment. He's praying. He's talking to the Lord. He's just waiting on the Lord. Amen. Every now and then you just need to be waiting on God. The Bible says that that's when Rebekah shows up, right at the time he's praying. Abraham is praying. The servant is praying. Isaac is meditating, contemplating in prayer when his blessing shows up. Oh, what Isaac did not know is that his blessing was looking at him before he saw her. Oh, y'all missed that. Look, he went out to the field that evening, and as he looked up, he saw camels approaching. Rebekah also looked up and saw Isaac. Look, Isaac saw the camels, but Rebekah saw her new husband. Oh, I want to kind of give you this shout right now. Your blessing is looking for you. Your blessing is looking for you. She saw her blessing, and he saw camels, but she saw her blessing. Oh, you ought to get excited. He was praying. He was faithful right where he was supposed to be, doing what he was supposed to do. And his blessing saw him a mile away. Oh, look, she got blessed and he got blessed. Oh, everybody's getting blessed in this text. Amen. His blessing showed up. Look, her blessing showed up at her house, and his blessing showed up at his house. Oh, y'all, I'm trying to give you God some praise. Her blessing showed up when she was faithful doing getting the water. His blessing showed up when he was faithful in prayer. He's out there and meditating. That's probably something he had done before, probably something he had been used to doing. Amen. Both blessings showed up while they're praying and looking and seeking the Lord Almighty. Beloved, your blessing is looking for you. Your blessing is coming your way. God is working on something for you behind the scenes. Amen. So he can bless you in public. Oh, let's give God some praise today. Oh, I just want to encourage somebody today. I know you're waiting. Be faithful. I know you're discouraged. Be faithful. I know it's gone longer than you expected. Be faithful. Guess what? Because your blessing's going to find you in your faithfulness. Hallelujah. Let's give God the praise this morning. I hope the word blessed you. I hope something fell into your spirit and is going to keep you through the week. Let's pray. God, we thank you. We thank you for what you're doing. We thank you, Lord, for sending the blessing while we're faithful. Lord, so help us to be faithful. Oh, what would have happened if Rachel was not out there on that day? Oh, what would have happened if she wasn't right where she was supposed to be? Oh, Lord, right now, I thank you, God, that you blessed her. Lord, so help us to be faithful. Help us to be grateful and help us to be ready. Amen. When our blessing shows up, when that opportunity, because that blessing is looking for us. Amen. You've dispatched the blessing. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name, we thank you, Lord. Speak to someone's heart. In the name of Christ, we pray. And all the people of God said, amen. Now, you would think that that was the sermon. You would think that that's really the text. That's the text on the surface. This is a deeper meaning of the text. Abraham in the text, in the beginning of the text, is like God our Father, who sends his master to find the bride of Christ. In scripture, Jesus is like a bride. Amen. We are like, and so hold on. He, what is this thing? What is going on? This is the picture. God sends out his faithful servants to seek out those who are his chosen. Ready to go, and Rebekah was ready to go. When your blessing comes looking for you, you better be ready to receive it. You better be moved and get into action. There's somebody here, you've been waiting on a job. Amen. You may have to wait longer than you expected, but when it comes, you better let them folk find you faithful. You better be grateful for the opportunity, and you better be ready to start day one. Oh, you don't need to look every now and then. You ain't got time. The Bible said they got packed and they got on out of here. Amen. Beloved, let me tell tell you something. When your blessing shows up, don't you be waiting around. Don't you be looking around. It kills me. Folk get a great job opportunity. They say, well, what you talking about? You've been praying on that thing. What you talking about? This is your opportunity. This is your moment. Don't waste it. Jump on it. Don't let it get past you. Beloved, there's some opportunities that are going to come your way. Your blessing's going to show up. God has been working on some stuff you didn't know about. Let God find you faithful. But when it shows up, you better praise God. You better be grateful. You better worship him. You better ask that God, you bless me. Success. But look, don't stop at the praise. You be ready to go. You be ready to move forward. Praise the Lord. Some opportunities are coming your way. And when them opportunities come, you got to be ready. But look, first thing is you got to be faithful. Notice all throughout the scripture, Abraham prayed. His servant prayed several times. Now, I didn't even read the end. When they get to, they travel and they get to where they're supposed to be. You got to read the end. The Bible says that Isaac was praying when they find him. You got to read that in the end. The Bible says when you get to the end, the Bible says this, verse 62, we didn't read it. Now Isaac had come from Beer Lahoroi, and he was living in the Negev. He went out to the field one evening to meditate. Amen. He's just going to sit out there and think on the goodness of the Lord. Now he doesn't know what the servant has found. He doesn't know the servant is about to show up. He's praying. You know why he's praying? Because he's seen his daddy pray. You know why he's praying? He had seen the servant that Abraham sent out pray. He had grown up in a praying household at this moment. He's praying. He's talking to the Lord. He's just waiting on the Lord. Amen. Every now and then you just need to be waiting on God. The Bible says that that's when Rebekah shows up. Right at the time he's praying. Abraham is praying. The servant is praying. Isaac is meditating, contemplating in prayer when his blessing shows up. Oh, what Isaac did not know is that his blessing was looking at him before he saw her. Oh, y'all missed that. Look, he went out to the field that evening, and as he looked up, he saw camels approaching. Rebekah also looked up and saw Isaac. Look, Isaac saw the camels, but Rebekah saw her new husband. Oh, I'm going to kind of give you this shout right now. Your blessing is looking for you. Your blessing is looking for you. She saw her blessing, and he saw camels, but she saw her blessing. Oh, you ought to get excited. He was praying. He was faithful right where he was supposed to be, doing what he was supposed to do. And his blessing saw him a mile away. Oh, look, she got blessed and he got blessed. Oh, everybody's getting blessed in this text. Amen. His blessing showed up. Look, her blessing showed up at her house. And his blessing showed up at his house. Oh, y'all, I'm trying to give you God some praise. Her blessing showed up when she was faithful doing getting the water. His blessing showed up when he was faithful in prayer. He's out there and meditating. That is probably something he had done before, probably something he had been used to doing. Amen. Both blessings showed up while they're praying and looking and seeking the Lord Almighty. Beloved, your blessing is looking for you. Your blessing is coming your way. God is working on something for you behind the scenes. Amen. So he can bless you in public. Oh, let's give God some praise today. Oh, I just want to encourage somebody today. I know you're waiting. Be faithful. I know you're discouraged. Be faithful. I know it's gone longer than you expected. Be faithful. Guess what? Because your blessing's going to find you in your faithfulness. Hallelujah. Let's give God the praise this morning. I hope the word blessed you. I hope something fell into your spirit and is going to keep you through the week. Let's pray. God, we thank you. We thank you for what you're doing. We thank you, Lord, for sending the blessing while we're faithful. Lord, so help us to be faithful. Oh, what would have happened if Rachel was not out there on that day? Oh, what would have happened if she wasn't right where she was supposed to be? Oh, Lord, right now, I thank you, God, that you blessed her. Lord, so help us to be faithful. Help us to be grateful and help us to be ready. Amen. When our blessing shows up, when that opportunity, because that blessing is looking for us. Amen. You've dispatched the blessing. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name, we thank you, Lord. Speak to someone's heart. In the name of Christ, we pray. And all the people of God said, amen. Now, you would think that that was the sermon. You would think that that's really the text. That's the text on the surface. This is a deeper meaning of the text. Abraham in the text, in the beginning of the text, is like God our Father, who sends his master to find the bride of Christ. In scripture, Jesus is like a bride. Amen. We are like, and so hold on. He, what is this thing? What is going on? This is the picture. God sends out his faithful servants to seek out those who are his chosen.